Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4, where we are the Unpronounceable Alliance. As always, we have left off on an amazing note, or more of a sort of cliffhanger. I mean, the borders are fixed, and I have fucking Ospreysen. Yes.
I lost Sardinia.
I put the fucking in front of the Ospreysen. That is right, and he doesn't have Sardinia, but nobody cares. I mean, what?
I would
have cared.
The thing. Poland got greedy and sneaked Sardinia in when nobody was looking.
That seems to be the misnomer of this playthrough, so. That's okay.
Poland's fast. It is Poland's fast.
It's the usual cast. We got Golden Self in Romania. We got the Strategy Gamers in Yugoslavia and Alex Berg in Poland.
Hi. Hi there.
So. Okay, we're ready to go. I started.
Cool.
So you did.
I should probably start doing things with my factories. That might be a good idea now that I actually have some. Just max out everything.
This is amazing.
I've literally maxed out everything, and I still have factories left over. I'm going to build
gonna
tanks.
Take me,
it's going to be awesome.
125 days to justify against Finland, and Finland is also being guaranteed by France, so this is...
going to war with Finland will bring us to the Allies. Let me check on Iran here. I'm going to justify Finland and see if France guarantees
a lot of things that...
Netherlands joined the Allies in Belgium.
Luckily for me now, I actually have my own war to fight once I go to
likewise,
war.
I'm justifying that Iran now.
Like
if we have to fight the
Allies, Yugoslavia and Poland are going to be in Western Europe, and then Romania gets all of the south, and I get the north, so it works out.
Oh crap! I have zero convoys.
Well, I have.
I can give you convoys.
That's okay. I can produce 2 per week. It'll be fine. If you have a bunch of free convoys, I would just.
I have 110 convoys. Sorry, which country are you again?
Oh, save your 110. That's not enough just if I give you me them.
I have 152.
Yeah, if you had like 800, I'd be like, yeah, throw 100 my way. But...
Well, I'm producing 3.3 a week. Yeah, I'd be producing more, but I don't have oil, so. Wait, I can synthesize oil. Aha.
I've never tried.
Bull.
Just buy oil from me. I have
what,
a lot of
Poland.
Romania, friend, but give me everything.
The German Poland. Army is marching home.
Oh god.
Oh those
yeah,
poor
I saw
bastards.
That for all of you that haven't seen, oh my god!
You think they're gonna disband their troops at all, or what?
They're not.
They can't support that.
They've got 100 divisions.
Oh,
there's
no way
they can
support that.
Support all of that.
Sure they can.
Not necessarily. You've taken half of it.
They've only got 100 divisions now. They used to have more, didn't they?
Mm-hmm.
And then we surrounded them and the tank that could. You guys remember that?
It's still Hitler. We didn't oust Hitler. He's still in charge.
Oh, no. Hitler is Hitler's fam, man.
Hitler, yeah. Hitler's going to be with the winning side.
He declared war.
He's a humble man, after all.
I forgot, guys. Greece is still a part of our faction.
God damn it, Greece.
Oh, yeah.
I wanted Greece. That's all I wanted.
Can we kick them out?
Nope.
Seriously?
They're not even fascist.
All right. Well, I'm making them fascist as we speak. Yeah, exactly.
Because then they'll get more men, yeah.
The Hellenic Empire.
We're going to make them fascist. It's going to happen.
No, I think it's a good idea to make them fascist.
Move on.
Because then at least they'll be more useful.
And I can't dismantle the faction, so no, there's
okay,
no way
to get
away. Okay,
yeah, United Kingdom started guaranteeing Iran once I just started
justifying
on them.
Oh, yeah, so this is basically, we have to go fight the Allies next. Yeah. That's just happening.
Or take a look at Japan. Japan still has no faction.
I don't know.
German Reich is improving relations with Japan.
We could just, we could just invite Japan.
Poland, you're justifying on Japan, I see, okay.
What?
I'm here to justify on Xinjiang, I guess. Wait, should I or 10-2?
Gosh, are you kidding me? I'm not even gonna be able to defeat Poland on my own. Or maybe I am. I guess all my troops aren't there.
I can fight 10-2.
I meant Finland.
What are you talking about?
I meant Finland. Calm down.
Because I'm totally with you if you'll give me Sardinia. I'm right there, man.
No, I don't care anymore. I just
whole
wanted...
Sardinia thing is going to come bite me in the ass.
It is.
I should be able to fight Tanutuva and Mongolia on my own. Because that's common turn, and they shouldn't have anybody joining to defend that.
That's true.
That is absolutely true.
That's a quick war, but it's for really land that doesn't matter at all.
Well, you see,
can
the best thing about our...
Can we wait a while for a war? Because I have no resources at all.
Well, I guess you could.
Shit.
Can we go up to 3-speed? Those before we go to war with
Japan,
wait,
before you do anything, go up to 3-speed for the love of everything.
Like, I need a lot of trade and equipment before I can afford to go to war again.
Okay. Now it's not like a snail's pace.
Yeah,
phase.
I think we talked about this, that after this war, we would need to spend some time building up.
Yeah,
I think
that's
we said
true.
That after the last war, actually.
Yeah, we said that.
Yeah. We've said that quite a few times.
I could use some... how many troops do I have?
I know.
I have 23 troops.
Yeah, no, it's okay. I have 24, and it's not going to get any bigger for me, so there's that.
But I could have a lot more.
I'm actually really confused. It smells like alcohol in my room.
It's
that's
synesthesia.
Not a good thing. I think that's called... That's not a good thing.
That's a tumor.
Yeah, you're right. God, don't say that. He could be right.
Yeah, actually, we shouldn't be laughing.
Got a tumor. I knew that in college you had a brain tumor.
No, I don't have a brain tumor. I
but
feel like
might.
I just left.
It's
yeah, okay, and you might have testicular cancer, but I don't think that happened.
It can happen. Like I said, I knew a guy, he was 22, and he got a brain tumor. He survived, thankfully. So to speak, defeated it, but,
well, people
you know,
do get cancer. Yeah, that's
at really rare young ages.
I know, that's what I'm saying. It's like, these are all possible things.
Like don't joke about it.
Thing.
He really could have a brain tumor.
We
I can't joke about anything that's
guys,
possible.
Guys, we can't joke about anything. It's possible that it could actually happen.
Hey, we joked about the Soviet Union declaring war on us. Look what happened. We joked
exactly.
about Germany declaring war on us. Look what happened. We
Illuminati confirmed.
War. Look
I
what
mean,
happened.
At least you got Ostprusen.
Yes.
You can die happy.
Pretty much.
No complaints.
Like, can I just comment on the fact that I have 1.75 million manpower?
Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I don't
know. I mean, it's that service by requirement. But
yeah,
I'm
actually,
bad.
Considering what all the stuff we just took, I still only have less than 1 million. I have 900K.
Okay, you guys are all over there. I'm at all adult serve, and I have 134 grand.
Yeah, but you've been doing, like, a lot of work with that.
Right, but that's not like it's a good thing. Like, I'm not yet scraping the barrel, but damn, I'm going to be soon.
Well, that's why we need a chance to build up. Especially in manpower, because it will go up over time with the amount of land you
yeah.
own.
Yeah, I mean, it goes up by 1,000 per month.
I think mine goes up by... recruitable is the amount it goes up by month, right?
Yeah.
Then mine's 3,160,000 a month. You should be able to send manpower to other nations. I wish you could do that, because that would be so easy.
It's called expeditionary forces.
Yeah, as I say, you can just send troops.
Yeah, but it caps the troops you can send, though. It caps you at such a low limit sometimes.
I think you're talking about volunteers, though.
Yeah.
Volunteers, you can. Yeah, the other thing, you can send as much as you want.
True.
You send your whole army if you want to do that.
Volunteers, you control expeditionary forces. It's basically like...
Oh, yeah, you know, no, you're right.
Volunteers is like the Canotieri.
Or the Condor Legion.
The what?
Yeah.
The Condor Legion from the Civil War in Spain. That's what the Germans were called, or the Air Force at least was called the Condor Legion.
I'm trying to make it relatable in another game's context.
I know.
Yeah, cool. I didn't get it at first because I haven't played around much with that patch.
Yeah, I've never once used Canotieri, but that's just because I don't play multiplayer usually.
I haven't played EU4 in so long, and I just started playing it again, and it's like, what are all these things?
Yeah.
It's a new game.
I don't know, I'm kind of scared, though, because in EU4, I feel like I'm just going to end up taking over the world, and that's kind of boring.
It's definitely a different beast.
Hey, the 12th Olympics were held.
Nice.
Hooray for Henry.
Who won it? I didn't read that pop-up.
Oh, I don't even think I got it. I was not paying attention.
Is there a message setting? Wait a minute. Are there message settings in this game?
Nope.
Yes.
What?
I swear there was.
There is?
I swear.
I haven't seen them. So maybe not. Unless they're like in the configs and stuff, the config files.
I swear I've seen possible. Them.
Yeah, oh I have my 10 submarines.
God, I have crappy divisions.
Yeah, I just added a bunch of tanks to my divisions.
I think the only reason my fleet survived that war is because they're all submarines.
Guys, I figured out why it smells like alcohol in my room. I don't know, it's not alcohol, but it's like, I like opened up my bag from
rotting
like,
juice.
Okay, I guess that's technically true, it fermented. But I opened up my bag like that I had for my vacation, and there's something inside of it that just smells awful.
That's it.
That's it.
All right,
I've got my subscriber fleet ready to go.
Your subscriber fleet?
Yeah.
Yes, synthetic oil.
10 subscribers. I'm doing really good.
I see.
Wait, what do you mean by subscriber fleet?
My subscriber fleet. They're in Constanta.
Oh, you're naming ships after, like, I should probably. Hello?
No, that would be smart, actually, if I did name them after individual subscribers, I guess. Okay, I kind of hate it when... I don't hate it, but I'm not a fan of that, generally speaking. When YouTubers do that kind of stuff.
Wow.
It's even more narcissistic than the whole YouTuber concept to begin with. It's like false modesty. But that's just
here
my opinion.
I am opening up my subscriber list right now so that they can be glorious divisions in the Lithuanian Iron Wolves. How dare you!
For all you guys watching that, if you want to be a division, message me now.
Visit my Patreon.
Check out my Patreon.
Yeah, guys.
Check it out. $1 buys you a division name. $5 buys you a fleet name.
Oh my God.
I'll create
Don't
a general.
Joke.
I'll
like that, I'm sure that's a thing.
General.
Okay, first division, one division. Well, I don't know how to change names, so this is actually a problem.
Actually, I'm not... Is there a way to actually change the division, like the fleet names? The divisions?
Oh, there we go. First division is...
Oh no, here it is, I found it.
Techzona.
Yeah, you can do it.
Yeah, good job, Techzona. You comment a lot, and that's why you're mean. Second one,
you're making the rest of us look bad.
We got Dominic.
You know what? Let me grab out this. I'm going to go do that too.
I realize you're just making Dominic fun of it, but you're starting to make us look bad.
We got Dominic D over here. He said, make Lithuania great again. Thanks, man.
Thanks, man. Thanks for contribution.
Yeah, thanks for the $1.
Thanks for support. We got a great community.
I just saw this betting sites where you can bet on Hearts of Iron outcomes, and it's really great. So. If you want to go
Hebo
check that
Jevo,
out.
Thanks, man. Really appreciate it.
Oh. Hearts of Iron Lotto.
Should we just international championships for this game?
Haja.
Represent your country today.
Maza. Thanks, man. Really appreciate it. Okay, let's see. So we got 4 division names. We need more. Let's go to another video. I mean, not much is really going on anyway. Okay, let's see. We got Johnny Bombardock. Okay.
Thank you, Johnny.
Yep, thanks, Johnny.
Whatever way people may have found in the past to justify where legionary Romania ends and Iran begins, we live in a new era.
That is true. That is definitely true.
I don't know if it's helpful. I just got transferred.
All these years, we've had these borders with legionary Romania and Iran, and what do they really mean anyway?
Right?
I mean, there's lines on a piece of paper, I mean...
Right?
There are some words here, but they could mean anything.
Go anyway.
Pretty much, honest.
I'm gonna go back to limited conscription once I get 300 political points, because I hate this, all the debuffs I'm getting.
Oh, guys! Turkey is the leader of the Axis.
What?
Turkey is Axis, and nobody else is Axis.
Oh yeah, we can declare war on Turkey.
Turkey.
You guys go for
that. I don't
have
the chips there right now. Wait a minute. So
I have 15 divisions. They will be sensed. But
wait a
Greece,
minute.
We're going to have to be careful, though.
I don't need divisions to do Tanituva and Mongolia, right? No.
The only thing is Greece is going to get land. Greece is going to get the participation if
we
push from
their
side. You're
right. That is the only thing.
No,
still, a stronger Greece.
We could cut them off, though. We could cut them off from Romania.
Yeah.
I have 15 divisions.
Don't call them in.
Oh, yeah, we don't have to call them in.
True.
Okay, wait a minute. Let me reorganize my troops a bit. And of course,
don't call me in. Just go do it on your own.
Yeah.
Istanbul, otherwise, you'll end up with Romanian Polish Ankara play. Or something.
It's funny because it's so true.
What?
Right? It's so. I forgot to go offline again.
Oh, good for you.
Okay, we're offline.
What do you mean?
Oh, I'm Steam. I need to go offline on Steam because my friends are always going online and offline, so I get a sense of message.
I think you have that turned off because I never get that.
Oh, I get it all the time.
I think there's a way to do it without going offline. Anyway, whatever. It's not important.
You can tell Steam to stop bothering you.
Yeah, exactly.
Damn it, Steam, stop bothering me, please.
Well.
It's like when Steam starts glitching out, it tells you somebody's online 5 times in a row, and it's like, okay, calm down, I get it. Read, buddy. I get it, they're online.
Steam's that spastic buddy of yours going, God, dude, totally.
Read it out, buddy. It's all good. It's all good.
He's online. He's totally online.
You should get really hyped. You have this game in common. You should go play it.
Yes.
The solution is just to not have any friends.
Well, that's true.
That got dark. True, but unfortunate.
Oh my god, there are like 50,000 Germans lost in the forest in the middle of Siberia.
Really?
Seriously?
Where? Yeah, they're just standing
Oh my
there.
God.
Dude, they're protecting Kubyshev.
Yeah, three
Those
panzer...
are some brave soldiers right
three
there.
Three panzer divisions and two motorized divisions and 10 infantry divisions are protecting the Iron Wolf in the middle of... Well...
What?
I would
yeah,
say
no
nowhere,
joke.
But...
What the hell?
But yeah, that's
okay.
That's the AR for you.
Those are some brave soldiers fighting off those trees.
Yep.
Keep fighting the good fight.
They could be finished trees.
So maybe we hold off on fighting the Allies then, for now.
Sure.
Sure, do some small wars.
I don't think we're ready for that
Yeah,
war.
We'll do some small wars and then we'll come after them.
Yeah, course, there's a few countries.
We can probably defeat them before the U.S. gets strong.
Strong.
But...
Sure. True. Whatever.
Yeah, but at this point, we're strong enough
to hold off the U.S. together. And eventually go invade them.
I can help you with Tanituva in Mongolia, if you want.
Tanituva? Oh, thank you.
I can do that for you.
No, that's alright. I've got five divisions.
I wouldn't trust him with that. I wouldn't be trusting him with any wars at this point.
I don't trust him with Tanituva or Mongolia.
Okay, I'll take Mongolia.
Anywhere where he's a border. Even places where he doesn't have a border. Like Sardinia.
Well, I can go declare war in Finland. Not going to, but I could.
Have we looked at a nationalist Spain yet? Can that happen? Or Portugal, maybe?
What about him? Like, can we attack him?
Yeah, or do you think they'll join the Allies? Well, Portugal probably
would. I think they probably will. Both of them.
You know what would be really nice? If Turkey started inviting a bunch of people to their faction. Like, if they bring in Spain,
right?
That would be perfect. We need that to happen.
Okay, so I'll hold off. I just got the war goal against Iran, but I guess I'll hold off on doing that.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
So, who's declaring on Turkey?
Whoever.
I'll declare on them. I'm just spying on them right now.
Okay.
Mechanized.
If we declare separate wars, does it become one war or something?
Soft attack.
Probably.
Does it really matter?
Probably not.
Oh my gosh! Okay, you know that? You know when you gave me roads? Pause it. Mm-hmm. I just noticed something.
Yeah, you have a straight crossing.
I'm going there right now.
Yeah.
That's
why roads
I
are
just saw that.
Yugoslavia.
I probably didn't need to pause it, but
Yugoslavia is like, really this is how I'm gonna get a bunch of territory for myself.
I'm doing it. I call tips.
You could take like the three south like territories. That looks bad.
Yeah. I feel bad. Iron Wolf Lithuania, if you declare war on Finland, you just risk all of the allies walking up to you.
No, you don't understand. Like,
no.
Finland is guaranteed by France.
So exactly. You can't do Finland?
Well, I can when
but
we're
not
ready
right
to
now.
Go. Yeah.
You're too good. Your country is too powerful. You'll get them. You'll win.
Oh, yeah. No.
We won't help you, but you'll win. We just don't want to get involved for other reasons.
Yeah, yeah, no, no, I just have, like, half of all your guys' factories.
Yeah, okay. You know what? We're not getting involved because we believe in you and that you can do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Face off France, America, Britain, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, British Raj. All you can do it.
We believe yeah, yeah, you. No, no, I got you. I got you.
Belgium, Netherlands. Oops. Who else is there? What are we missing here? Do they have Denmark yet? Did that happen?
No, that didn't happen. I don't think so. Maybe.
Oh shit, I gotta go to war before 28th of February.
Why?
With Japan. A research transport ship.
Because that's when my claim expires.
On who?
Ah, yes.
What was it again?
Japan.
Oh, are you gonna need help with that?
Nippon.
Probably. You're gonna need a lot of troops for that, right?
Yep.
Because I don't think you have enough to win that, just looking at the border.
And looking at their troop numbers, they've got like 200-something troops.
Yep.
And so we're kind of busy with Turkey.
Kind of a mistake on my part.
Well, you don't have to.
Yeah, you might
want
it to
right
wait.
Now.
Yeah, you might want to.
But don't I lose national unity when the thingy expires?
Probably. Yeah.
I never did, unless I didn't notice it.
I should have canceled my war goal on Iran when I had a chance. Yep. In Tanituva. Oh, I can cancel on Tanituva. Oh wait, but why would I? They're in the Comintern. But yeah, Iran's going to hit me. It's only like 5%, though. You Iran's also lose a slight allies. Amount of fascists as well.
We're so close.
How are we going to this? Legionary Romania will finish justifying on 29th of March in Turkey.
Where the... Where
to be
are
honest,
you?
I'm not sure I have enough to invade them from the east
to...
and the west.
I can help out.
So important.
Don't trust him.
Max, maybe.
The only people invited to this party, the only person invited to this party is Yugoslavia. And even that is a bit of a stretch.
Don't worry, I'm not going to take much. I'll probably just take like a small amount of the entire thing, you know.
I mean, you can take some stuff around Rhodes, I think.
Oh yeah, I'll probably. Yeah, I'm not gonna like expand too deep because it just doesn't look right. Because Greece is gonna be.
All
right,
guys.
Me.
I named my whole army. You know, subscribers. You know.
Oh, that's what you've been doing.
except that I have one division called Grimmick and another division called also Grimmick, but that's okay.
I feel like you're because you're two of your own subscribers. Is that what it is?
Actually, yes, no, exactly.
Just other accounts.
My plan has been foiled.
We know what you're up to.
How to be big on YouTube.
Yeah, subscribe
make
to yourself.
Make millions of accounts.
Make two of your own accounts. That's all you need.
The wheel on my mouse all of a sudden just got really, really sticky.
See that? I'll call it.
Not sticky, but it's not going... smoothly. I don't know how to describe
Ooh,
it.
Ooh, the Germans found their maps again.
Oh, really?
Yep.
They invented GPS.
Congratulations.
They can
bit confused,
attention
but...
away from war and toward technology.
Yeah, only the... Well, they're going a little bit... They're going here and there. That's...
Here and...
Romania does not start with any ships researched. At all, except for, for destroyers and submarines.
I'm only just starting my planes.
Yeah, ditto. I had destroyers and submarines too.
Yeah, I don't have enough factories to do that.
I have nothing. Yugoslavia starts with my best ships are from 1922. My navy is horrible.
All right, guys, we're starting the. We're gonna make some tanks. Yeah.
I've already started making tanks.
Well, yeah, good for you, but,
we need... Yugoslavia's glorious army of tanks that are outdated.
Concentrated industry 4 time.
I need to change some of this to get better tanks. I really do. Do I need atomic research? Is that something that I should have?
Not at this point, probably not. I usually go for that when I'm, like, out of everything else to research.
You're gonna research... medium tanks now, thank you.
Or like, if I've gone through everything at that tech, like at that year level, and I'm way ahead of time on research, basically, I'll go for atomic research. Whoa, so check out the Polish border with Japan and Mongolia.
I'm two focuses away, well, one focus away from getting technology sharing. Oh, dear. What happened here?
Poland, you're not allowed to justify Mongolia.
Says who?
Says me. I'm about to declare on Tanituva, which is going to be a war with Mongolia and Tanituva.
Oh, I'll help out them.
About that.
I need more border with Japan.
Oh. Do you really want more border with Japan?
Yeah, do you really need more border with Japan?
Yes.
I mean, you can't even cover what you already have, okay?
Mongolia is... We can't even split Mongolia. It's one state.
Oh my god, you're right.
I mean, I guess...
Seems like somebody made a mistake there.
If it's that worthless...
It's
13 slots. Tanituva is 9 slots.
Absolutely worthless. You can have them both.
You can have Mongolia, but I'm getting Xinjiang.
Okay.
When we go for that. Oh, no, wait. They're no faction, but they are communist. Interesting. So
oh,
if we...
Shit.
Wait a minute. So if
they're
I justify
join...
on them... Comintern, yeah.
The Germans are coming to help you guys. I just want you to know that.
The Germans are coming.
They still have those divisions stuck Central Russia. Oh man.
Wow, I have no construction happening right now. What the hell am I doing?
Yeah, what the hell are you doing?
What are you doing?
That's a question I ask myself every day. What the hell is Romania doing right now?
Oh, I'm building my tanks so slowly.
Holy crap. Western Slovakia has 6 spots. I thought it was a lot, but it's not.
6 slots. Whoa. Ooh,
so much slots.
Too many slots. Not enough space.
Such slots.
I want it back.
You can have Mongolia. I'm getting Xinjiang.
Okay.
Mongolia?
Uh-oh, Turkey's moved a division in to stop me.
Oh, no. 15, hey. Jesus Christ.
I think that's... We'll see how that goes over there. I feel
don't
like you're
going
to have some attrition when you land on the mainland Turkey, but
I don't
we'll
think
see.
So, actually.
No, because I still have connection to the ports, right? Because it's a bridge, technically.
Yeah.
You're not going
what's
across.
What's the supply limit on that port? Throughput is 12. Okay, yeah, it should be fine. Maybe.
And I actually just noticed I have more islands, so I'm sending them across to that side, too.
Yeah, so you do.
Oh, wait,
and
can
it's
I
probably
invade
same...
from there?
Yeah, it's the same state, so interesting. So you have actually 2 ports there.
Yeah, which is going to be useful.
Very interesting.
Yeah, these islands were surprisingly useful, and we got them just because nobody else wanted them.
Well, don't count your chickens before they hatch, but yeah.
Duh.
Let's see. Finland. Oh, Finland. I have to justify another war goal because mine already expired. But that's probably not going to happen, so...
Well, don't start a war with them because we're not helping you.
Yeah,
I'm not getting another war.
Duh.
I have no troops on the French border at all.
I'm just letting my manpower
grow.
Turkey
has, 500 planes, I guess. It's not nothing.
It's not nothing.
Okay, so I have 95% fascist, right? But then 0 of everything else.
Yeah, so you don't have to worry about losing losing support for fascism.
No, I know, but it's like I have there's 5% that just isn't represented.
I don't understand what the non-aligned means, to be honest. Like they're like dictatorships, but that doesn't make them fascist.
Monarchies, a lot of monarchies.
But it's still basically something or other.
Constitutional
monarchy or absolute monarchy or whatever.
Yeah, some of them are absolute.
They didn't put in enough work is what I'm
saying. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Like Norway non-aligned is a constitutional monarchy. Sweden non-aligned is a constitutional monarchy. If you do the console command for Burgundy and France, or no, what?
There, you can do that?
Yeah.
You can release Burgundy?
Well, it becomes Burgundian France. It's just... No, not Burgundian. What's that liquor again?
Bourbon.
Bourbon France.
Oh.
Yeah.
I should probably get weapons too at some point.
Yeah, that would probably be
Tuba.
I've been really behind on my research.
Wait, you don't even have weapons too?
No, I've been busy getting other stuff. I did not start with a lot of stuff. I mean, trying to catch up on my industry and such. I don't need planes, do I? I could switch that.
Alright, Tanituba, rip! Done. Get wrecked.
Good luck, friend. Watch Japan declare war out of you on you.
Oh, all I need to do is get them to capitulate. Send volunteers requests from Japan.
They want to help out. Yeah, that's awesome.
I need their help too.
Do you really?
My guys can't enter from Poland. Crap. Okay. I thought this was going to be easier than it is, apparently.
Those German divisions don't know where they're going at all.
You need my help to actually do that war.
I don't really think so.
You can't cross
the
border.
But thanks for offering.
You can't cross the border from where you're standing.
Yeah,
oh,
no,
you do have a border with them.
I'm working on it.
I didn't realize
you had
a border.
Around. It's okay. Somehow I think we can manage.
I think you'll do fine.
How much longer until that war goal on Turkey is done?
Let me see.
Well, it doesn't matter how much longer for that war goal, because that's the end of the episode. I'm going to pause right here.
Oh, shoot. Yeah.
I'd like to thank you guys for watching. If you
We have it. We can declare a war on Turkey anytime.
And
that will
check
be next
out
episode.
Each other's perspectives. Next episode. Don't interrupt me. Yeah. Peace.
Interrupting.
Sorry.
Bye.